Okay, hey y'all. Today I was on a little road trip outside of town, and I had a tiny amount of spending money, and I stopped at two places. I had $8 total, and I stopped at a comic book store in a small town, and I had $5 to spend there. And so I was checking out. They had a nice 50-cent bin that I was looking through. That was mostly superhero comics, which I'm not really interested in. And the owner came over and said, "Hey, what are you looking for? Anything I can help you find?" And I said, "Well, do you have any milk and cheese or Ralph Snart?" And I asked a few other things. And he said, "No, I've never heard of most of that stuff, but I do have some milk and cheese that I just got in yesterday." And he came out and he brought me this stack that was taped together. And it's issues 1 through 5 for $4.99. And with my $5 budget, this was perfect. So I got these 5 issues of Milk and Cheese, the first 5. I don't know if there's even more than that, honestly. Today for $1 each, which I am super happy about. You can see another store sold these ones in the past. $3, $4. That's the third one. Here's the fourth one. The first, second issue, as they call it. Actually, this is the fifth one, sorry. This is the fourth one, which they wanted $10.50 for at some different store. And then here's the last, the fifth one. Okay. This cover is fantastic, by the way. Onward to Mayhem. So if you're not familiar with Milk and Cheese, which you're most likely not, unless you're into, comedy comics from the 80s and 90s. Milk and Cheese are a jug of milk named Milk and a block of cheese named Cheese. And they just happen to be sort of misanthropic alcoholics who basically get drunk and go smash and destroy things. And that's pretty much Milk and Cheese. It's a black and white comic. Started, I think, in the late 80s as sort of a serial in other comic collections, and then these standalone collections started to come out. Oh yeah, their tagline is "Dairy products gone bad." So the way that I first heard about these is the artist, whose name is Evan Dorkin, used to do album covers for ska and punk albums in the mid-90s. And we somehow figured out that he also did this comic book. A buddy of mine found out and told me about it, and I had a few issues back in the 90s, and I've been looking for them ever since. I don't know what happened to those. I lost them many, many years ago. And no one, I've never been able to find them, so I'm super happy for this low-cost sort of find. And one thing that I found was very interesting is that Evan Dorkin is still working these days, and he still has this sort of signature style. And he's been doing some strips for Mad Magazine. Very recently, in fact. He doesn't have, at least that I've seen, he doesn't have a regular strip. But I've seen more than one strip in, the last couple of years that he's drawn. And maybe even written as well. Here's Milk and Cheese. I remember this one on a sugar rampage. Now we're drunk. Alcohol rampage. Kids, don't give your dairy products alcohol because you never know what they're going to do next. Here they are going on a hammer. What is it? Anyways, they're going out hitting people with hammers. I don't know. Destroying stand-up comedians. I don't know. It's crazy juvenile stuff. But I think it was worth the $5 to check out. And, that's that. One of his signatures in these is you'll sometimes see punks and skinheads and rude boys and references to that sort of culture, which I always find interesting and nice. But, oh yeah, Dork, this is another one. I think they put out. Anyways, that's Milk and Cheese.